leading expert on discouraging men. I'll write a book about it. Girls, are you constantly bothered by the cloying attentions of the male sex? Well, here's the solution for you. Get Ruth Sherwood's new bestseller, 100 Easy Ways to Lose a Man. Chapter 1. Now, the first way to lose a man. It meant a charming fellow under a horse spin. The motor fails and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't back your eyes and say, what a romantic spot we're in. Just get out, crawl into the car, Thomas the gasket, fix it 2 seconds flat without him. That's a good way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game. Is it knee to knee? He says the next guy up in that room, what you'll see. Don't say, oh, where's the fun? This game's too hard for little me. Just say, bunt. What are you, nuts? With no outs, two men on base and a left-handed batter coming up, you'll walk right into a triple play just like it happened the fifth game of the World Series in 1923. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for a second base. 98 ways to go. The third way to lose a man. The lifeguard at the beach, that old girl he's a dope. Swims bravely out to save you from the ocean's roar. Don't say, oh, thanks. I want to drown in just 1 second more. Just push his head underwater, your last one is a rotten egg, and race him back to shore. That's a swell way to lose a man. You found your perfect mate, and it's been love from the start. He whispers, here's a one good one in my heart. Don't say, I love you, my dear. It's never, never. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give. See, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, and the use of the word whom imperative track can easily show me by drawing a very simple chart! Never.